हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज़। माय नेम इज़ आयुष मित्तल एंड टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट टू स्टेज एयर कंप्रेसर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, बिफोर गोइंग टू द वर्किंग ऑफ द एयर कंप्रेसर, लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स कंपोनेंट्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वी हैव आर टेम्परेचर मीटर विच इज़ यूज टू नो द टेम्परेचर ऑफ डिफरेंट पाइप्स कनेक्टेड टूवर्ड्स द सक्शन वॉल्व्स एंड मोटर्स। सेकेंड, वी हैव एम मीटर विच इज़ यूज टू नो द करेंट पास्ड इन द मोटर। थर्डली, वी हैव वोल्ट मीटर विच मेजर्स वोल्टेज अप्लाइड अक्रॉस द मोटर। एंड नाउ फोर्थ, वी हैव आर एनर्जी मीटर और वी कैन से पावर मीटर विच मेजर्स द पावर कंज्यूम बाय द मोटर। दिस इज़ द मेन स्विच विच इज़ यूज टू ऑन एंड ऑफ द मोटर। एंड हेयर आर द LED इंडिकेटर्स। दिस इज़ आवर पावर सप्लाई स्विच। एंड दिस इज़ अ यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर विच मेजर्स द प्रेशर डिफरेंस ऑफ द this is our suction box which sucks the air and the normal pressure. So U-tube manometer measures the pressure difference. Now as we can notice, this air suction box has a hole inside this. This hole is known as the orifice of the suction box. It is of two types, which are 10 mm and 15 mm. So in this box 10 mm suction orifice is connected. Now let's move ahead to the next components of the air compressor. Now here comes the main unit of the compressor, that is the motor and the piston. Here we have two pistons connected which compresses the air through air which comes through the suction pipe, pipe 1, pipe 2, and after compressing the air, the compressed air comes through this pipe. This is pipe 3 and goes to the tank capacity. This tank is of capacity 130 liters. These pistons are of diameter 70 mm and the length of the piston is 80 mm. This motor is of 3 horsepower, 1450 rpm and single phase motor, induction motor. Here we have our pressure gauge which is used to measure the pressure of the tank, and this is the power cutoff switch which cuts off the power when the pressure of our tank is greater than 10 kg per centimeter cube. And here we have our valve which is used for the outlet of the compressed gas from the valve. Okay, so let's move ahead to the working of the air compressor. So before owning the air compressor, first of all we have to fill this manometer to more than with water from more than a half. We can fill this with using this pipe. So now let's on the air compressor. As we can see, we have on the air compressor. So this manometer makes the difference in the pipes, both of the water. So, and here we can see the pressure gauge. The pressure of the pressure gauge is changing. So we have to wait until the pressure of the pressure gauge reaches 2.5 kg per centimeter square. So let's wait until. As we can see here, the pressure of the pressure gauge has reached 2.5 kg per centimeter square. So now we will open the valve and we will set the pressure of the pressure gauge to 2 so that it is stable. So we will keep open the pressure gauge at 2. As we can see, the needle of the pressure gauge is moving down towards the 2 kg per centimeter square. So let's wait, and as I can see, the pressure of the pressure gauge has reached to 2. So now I will close the valve to a limit so that it will stable at 2 only. So now we have to take the reading from the manometer. As you can see here, the difference of the pressure, here we can see the first H1 of the is 19.4. and the second height of our manometer is 14.4. So difference of these H1 and H2 will be 19.4 minus 14.4, that will be 5. So this is our first observation. Now for second reading, we will have to take the pressure of the pressure gauge to 3.5 kg per centimeter square. So let's make the pressure of the pressure gauge to 3.5 kg per centimeter square and wait until. As we can see, the pressure of the pressure gauge has reached 3.5 kg per centimeter square. So now let's open the valve to make a stable pressure at 3 kg per centimeter square. As you can see, the needle of the pressure gauge is moving down. So let's make it this needle stable at 3 kg per centimeter square. So here we know that this needle has come to 3 kg per centimeter square. So now let's measure the pressure from the manometer. As we can see, the reading of the manometer here as height 1 is approx 19 and height 2 is 14.8. So the difference of these will be 19 minus 14.8, that will be 4.2. So let's mark it in our observation. Okay, so after taking all the observations, we have to do calculations according to the calculations mentioned in the manual, so that we can measure the volumetric efficiency and the isothermal efficiency of the air compressor. Thank you guys for watching this video, and if you have any doubt regarding air compressor, you can go through the website Tesca Global. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and do subscribe to the channel. Thank you.